So that is incredibly inspiring to me, but it's also inspiring of putting humans onto other moons or planets. I still find going to the moon really exciting. I don't know, maybe I'm just a sucker for it, but it's really exciting. And Mars, which is a new place, a new planet, another planet that might have life. I mean, there's something magical to that, or some traces of previous life.
You might think that humans cannot really survive, and there are risks by going there. Yes. But my point is, you know, we started from Africa. Yeah. And we got to apartment buildings in Manhattan,
yes.
Right? It's a very different environment from the jungles to live in an apartment building in, you know, a small cubicle.
Yes.
And, you know, it took tens of thousands of years, but humans adapted, right? So why couldn't humans also make the leap and adapt to a habitat in space? You know that? Now, you can build a platform that would look like an apartment building in the Bronx or somewhere, but have inside of it everything that humans need.
Yes.
And it just like the space station, but bigger, and it will be a platform in space. And the advantage of that is if something bad happens on Earth, you have that complex where humans live, and you can also move it back and forth depending on how bright the sun gets. Because, you know, within a billion years, within a billion years, the sun would be too hot.
Yeah.
And it will boil off all the oceans on Earth. So we cannot stay here for more than a billion years, that's for sure.
Yes. So that's a billion years from now. I prefer like shorter term deadlines. And so there's a lot of threats that we're facing currently. Do you find it exciting, the possibility of, landing on Mars and starting little, like, building a Manhattan-style apartment building on Mars and humans occupying it? Do you think from a scientific or an engineering perspective that's a worthy pursuit?
I think it's worthy, but the real issue that is often underplayed is the risk to the human body from cosmic rays.
Right.
These are energetic particles, and we are protected from them by the magnetic field around the Earth that blocks them. But if you go to Mars, where there is no such magnetic field to block them, then a significant fraction of the brain cells in your head will be damaged within a year. And the consequences of that are not clear. I mean, it's quite possible that humans cannot really survive on the surface. Now, it may mean that we need to dig tunnels, go underground, or create some protection.
Mm-hmm.
This is something that can be engineered.
Yes.
And we can start from the moon and then move to Mars. That would be a natural progression. But it's a big issue that needs to be dealt with. I don't think, it's a showstopper. I think we can overcome it. But, you know, just like anything in science and technology, you have to work on it for a while, figure out solutions. But it's not as rosy as Elon Musk talks about. I mean, Elon Musk can obviously be optimistic. I think eventually it will boil down to figuring out how to cope with this risk, the health risk.
Yeah, I mean, in defense of optimism, I find that there's at least a correlation, if not their best friends, is optimism and open-mindedness is... But it's a necessary, it's preconditioned to try crazy things. And in that sense, the sense I have about going to Mars, if we use today's logic of what kind of benefits we'll get from that, we're never going to go. And like most decisions we make in life, most decisions we've made as a human species are irrational if you look at just today. But if you look at the long arc and the possibilities that it might bring, just like humans
left Europe and
went, destroyed everybody on the.
But it was a commercial interest that drove that for trade. And, you know, it might happen again in this context. You have people like Jeff Bezos and Elon Musk that are commercially driven to go to space.
Yes.
But it doesn't mean that what we will ultimately find is not new worlds, you know, that have nothing, you know, much more to offer than just commercial interests. And
yes. As a side effect almost, right?
Yeah. And that's why I think you know, we should be open-minded and explore. And however, at the same time, because of the reasons you pointed out, I'm not optimistic that we will survive more than a few centuries into the future, because people do not think long-term, and that means that we will only survive for the short-term.